Yeah, a great week for us. Two good wins, North Dakota at home and then NDSU at home to wrap up Frost Arena. Was a really, I thought, meaningful experience, and fans were incredibly, you know, gracious in being there and supporting the team, but also recognizing that last game, that last event in Frost Arena. And it wasn't a couple of hours after the game where the seats were taken down, the hoops were down, and really that was it. That was the last thing that was going to happen there. So I really appreciate the fans coming out and being a part of that. I know women's basketball was the event that day, but I'm sure our fans would have been there for any event because that building means a lot to them. No matter who's playing. So really want to say thanks to them. Fun to celebrate Tori on Senior Day. She did a great job. Those are emotional days, and I thought she was a great leader for us that day. And then to get two wins and finish off the regular season undefeated was really meaningful. You don't always start the season with some of those goals, but things and opportunities sometimes present themselves throughout the year, and I thought we made the most of those chances. So really feel good about the weekend. Now we're getting ready for the Summit League tournament. We do that by taking a little more time off this week. You know, we don't really have an opponent yet. We won't find out until Friday, so we get a chance to work on a lot of basic things, our things, things that are going to be universal, and that's good too. Sometimes when you go through the season, you just get into game plan mode and you lose some fundamental things. So this week we get a chance to go back and work on those. Great to see Brooklyn honored as the Peak Performer of the Week, too. She had a fantastic week and a huge part of what our success has been all year. I just think Brooklyn is an elite player and such a difference maker in so many ways for us on the floor. And every time she gets honored, I think it's really deserving because I think she's that good of a player for us. And so a lot of positives, a lot of momentum as we get ready for a fun conference tournament down in Sioux Falls.
Zimmer, do you have any questions for AJ? Oh. Andrew, how about you? Andrew Holden?
Yeah. AJ, do you, the confidence level of your team right now, it seems like you guys are playing your best basketball, obviously. You know, just how do you feel about that going into the conference tournament? It seems like you guys are just really playing confidently.
Yeah, I would agree with you. I think conference tournaments are about playing well in those moments. And anything you can take from the regular season to help you gain confidence in your plan, in execution, in making shots, and whatever it might be, I think is helpful. I think the other thing you have to do in conference tournaments is not only draw from the last several weeks and months, but also you just have to be super in that moment and try and do the best you can. And you don't get to stack up regular season wins to help you in a conference tournament. That's really all about that day. And so you have to be able to do both. Figure out what are we good at and make sure you maximize those things. And those are confidence pieces that you talked about. But then also be really present and ready to adjust and ready to handle the ups and downs and emotion that go into those individual games.
Kind of just touched on it a little bit, but there's been some upsets on the men's side, but not as many on the women's side. You know, what do you think it is about your team that in the past has been able to handle the pressure of the conference tournament and, you know, being in Sioux Falls and having, you know, such a large backing down there?
Yeah, well, we've been upset down there. It hasn't happened often, but it certainly has happened, and not that, you know, distant past. So we've been on both sides of it and kind of understand what goes well and what doesn't go well down there for us at times. And so it's just, I think, handling games. I think, you know, teams that can handle the ups and downs within a game and stay really steady, I think, are teams that seem to do well down there. When something doesn't go well for you in a game and then that compounds itself in that game, it's just hard to recover. You know, the games are short. They're only 40 minutes. It's not a two-month regular season thing, you know. And so you have to be just really present in the moments. So you have to know that there's going to be some things that don't go your way, missed shots, turnovers, plays that don't go the way we want. But there's just so many more chances to make positive plays and trying to stay focused on that rather than dwelling on a negative.
You guys don't know who you're playing. Is that hard at all, or does it not matter since you have already played those teams two times each?
Yeah, I think it's a little awkward. That's the word I would use for it. You know, everybody else right now all week is getting ready for somebody. you know, we're waiting, and we won't find out till Friday night, basically, who we're playing on Saturday in a pretty quick turnaround. So I think it's a little unique. So I don't think it's not manageable. I just think it's a little unique. We had the same scenario last year, obviously, with the two play-in games. So we'll have to figure out what we liked about what we did last year and what we need to get better with. But this week we'll spend a little time on both teams. You know, we have a lot of time this week. We'll try and get a thought on what we would do against either opponent, and then find out Friday night and put that plan in place.
Thanks, AJ.
Yep.
Anya, what questions do you have?
Hey, Coach. I just have two questions. Even looking back to the early moments of the North Dakota game, it seems as though teams are adjusting to how you use Brooklyn Meyer. As you prepare during this bye week, how are you going to just adjust to her being a target?
Yeah, no, I would agree with you. And we're seeing some things from teams that they're trying against us that we hadn't seen against other teams. And that's a good thing. I think it has a lot to do with Brooklyn inside, also a lot to do with Paige on the perimeter. They're both so dynamic, and they can create a lot of plays. But particularly inside with Brooklyn, how do people want to guard her one-on-one, but then how do they want to double, and what's their best way to do that? So I think we're seeing a lot of that, and we did against North Dakota, and we did against North Dakota State. And I think our team has adjusted. You know, I think we're just trying to keep things really simple and give some concepts, and then you rely on just the talent. And Brooklyn has grown so much in her ability to score, turn and see defenses, make the right pass. I would say 2 months ago that was kind of new. She was getting better with it, but where she's at now is fantastic. It's really a hard thing to do, and she's done a great job of it. And same with Paige. You know, people are guarding her differently in ball screens and trying to take away some of her strengths, and she's really adjusted. So just a lot of credit to those players and how they continue to grow and see what's happening against them.
Anya, did you have another question?
Yeah, I do. So, and speaking to just the team coming into this season, it seems as though that you guys had challenges to overcome. As the season went along, can you speak to the resiliency and determination of your team leading you guys to be undefeated in conference play?
Yeah, definitely some challenges. No doubt about it. Injuries are not easy to deal with. Then you have every other thing that comes up, season-ending injuries I'm talking about. Then you have all the other little things that come up throughout the year that maybe aren't season-ending, but you still miss time, or you have illnesses, you have short-term things, you have the pressure that goes into being successful, you have the craziness of scheduling travel and what goes into that. I mean, there's just all kinds of reasons not to be at your best all the time. And when you can go through and be a championship-level team in the regular season and then get to a point where you're undefeated, during that two-month span, you found a way to be at your best a lot. And that says a lot about our team's resiliency and how they support each other, how they compete for each other, how they hold each other accountable. It's not just 16 games that we won. It's all of the days where games weren't happening, and choices and practice and recovery and how they rest. And there's just so many things that have to happen over that couple of months span to be at that level. That means they really care a lot about one another to make those choices consistently throughout the year. And that's fun to see as a coach. You know, we love winning and love hoisting a trophy, and those championships are fun. But it's really fun to see a team come together and really support each other in a way that this team has.
I just have one more. Going back to you talking about just, you know, the recovery process, how are you guys going to recover in this bye whilst preparing for an opponent that you guys don't even know about?
Yeah, you know, we've adjusted everything that we've typically done. This has been a different year for us with our practice routine, days off, days that we go harder, days that we go lighter. It's really been a completely different routine this year. So even this week, we'll have some differences compared to what we've done in the past. I think we're in a good place. Team kind of knows what we want. We try and be really specific about what days we're really going hard in practice, what days we're going to walk through, and we just try and sprinkle a little bit of both in. I still like throughout the year, quite honestly, even though we've had the injuries, we've never really had players that are just leading the league in minutes. We've still been able to keep people around, I think, a comfortable amount of minutes in games, and so now it's just about trying to make sure they recover well and stay fresh, and we've adjusted practices to help that out too.
That's all for me. Thanks, Coach.
Yep, thanks.
Zimmer, what do you got?
Hey, excuse me. Aaron, I was looking at Torrey Nelson's stats today, and I was kind of taken aback by how they're almost the exact same for five consecutive years. And I mean that in a good way. You know, I mean, the consistency has really been impressive. Never really been a superstar, obviously, but just kind of come to work and done the same thing every day for 5 years. Can you speak a little bit to the value in that consistency, sort of the role she's brought, and maybe even a little bit of the unselfishness that shows about her over the years?
Yeah, and I think I talked about it after the game too, but recognizing Torrey on her senior day or senior weekend, one of the things I think that stood out to me was just what her winning percentage has been here as a Jackrabbit. If you look at it overall or even just her conference winning percentage, she has not lost many conference games in her 5 years here. And so when you really define Torrey, you define Torrey from that perspective rather than just statistical. There's a lot of great stats there. She's, you know, scored over 1,000 points, block shot. I mean, there's a ton of really good stats. But the winner stat, the ability to help a team be successful, is the most valuable stat any player could ever bring. It, you know, that's the one that matters. We see a lot of really good players in our league that do fantastic things, but maybe haven't impacted winning quite as much. And like Torrey, that's exactly what she's done. And not only with her talent and ability, but to the word you used, kind of that unselfish nature of Torrey, most players crave a little more spotlight, or most players crave more minutes or more shots or more spotlight. And Torrey just really wants to help a team win. She wants to be as good as she can be for the team. It's really important for Torrey, but it's also really important for Torrey to see her teammates do well. And when you watch us play, you see us huddle, the team is talking, there's energy, but when there's something to be said, you know, all eyes are on Torrey, and she's earned that, and I think her team really respects her that way as a winner and somebody that knows what that takes.
Thanks, Aaron.
Yep.
Eric, do you have any questions?
Yeah. Hi, Coach. Thanks for taking the time. I'm just looking from afar. It seems like the team has been good at winning games, having that versatility and winning games, like with balanced scoring against UND versus having three players kind of get the bulk of the points offensively against North Dakota State. What have you just liked about the versatility and just different ways the team has shown to win games, both offensively and defensively?
Yeah, I think that is a great word. I think versatility is great for us this year. Every team has to have some go-to things, and we have go-to players. Like Paige and Brooklyn are elite. They can make a lot of plays. But we have a lot of things that our team does to try and put players in good spots too. And sometimes we've won against teams that play a lot of zone, so we're capable there. Sometimes we've done it with making a bunch of threes in a game. Sometimes we've made a couple of threes. We've scored in other ways. Sometimes it's all in the paint, getting to the basket, post touches. Sometimes defensively we've played a lot of our matchup stuff. Sometimes we've played a lot of zone. We've switched up how we handle a lot of different screens. So I really like that about our team. I think they do a great job all week of, you know, trying to think about schemes and trying to practice things that we think can be helpful when we get into games, and then they all adjust really well. And like I thought last year's team for us did a great job of that. We had so many just seniors and juniors and players that have been around for a long time. It's been great to see a relatively young team this year also be really good at that. And they've really worked hard at that, watching film, stuff they do in practice, and that's been a strength of ours, I think, and hopefully it will be going forward too.